pleasure in bringing to you the news and events of the world. Montebello, California. The sun rose this morning at 6:32 a.m. This gratifying event was first reported by Mrs. Dorothy Stetson of Montebello, California, who promptly telephoned the mayor. The Society for Affirming the End of the World at once went into a special session and postponed the arrival of that event for 24 hours. All honor to Mrs. Stetson for her public spirit. Los Angeles, California, the East Los Angeles College Theater Department. During the daily cleaning of this theater, a number of lost objects were collected, as usual, by Mrs. Eva de Jardin, Mrs. Edith Flores, and Alana is this nudo. Among these objects found today was a wedding ring inscribed to Eva from Milan, Genesis 2:18. The ring will be restored to the owner or owners if their credentials are satisfactory. Medford, Oregon. The unprecedented cold weather of this summer has produced a condition that has not yet been satisfactorily explained. There is a report that a wall of ice is moving southward across these counties. The disruption of communication from the cold wave now crossing the country has rendered exact information difficult. Little credence is given to the rumor that the ice has pushed the Cathedral of Montreal as far as St. Albans, Vermont. For further information, see your daily papers. Hacienda Heights, California, the home of Mr. George Antrides, the inventor of the wheel. The discovery of the wheel, following so closely on the discovery of the lever, has centered the attention of the country on Mr. Antrides of this attractive suburban residence district. This is his home, a commodious seven-room house conveniently situated near a public school, a Methodist church, a firehouse, and it is right handy to a superior. Mr. Antrides himself, he comes the very old stock and has made his way up from next to nothing. It is reported that he was once a gardener, but left that situation under circumstances that have been variously reported. Mr. Antrides is a veteran of foreign wars and bears a number of scars front and back. This is Mrs. Antrides, the gracious and charming president of the Hacienda Heights Mothers Club. Mrs. Antrides is an excellent needlewoman. It is she who invented the apron on which so many changes have been rung since. Here, you see the Antrideses and their two children, Henry and Gladys, and friend. Friend of the rare is Lily Sabina May. I know we all want to congratulate this typical American family for its enterprise. We all wish Mr. Antrides a successful future. Now, the management takes you into the interior of this home for a brief visit.
Anything to eat? In the midst of life, we are in the midst of death. A truer word was never said. Of course, Mr. Antrobus is a very fine man, an excellent husband, father, a pillar of the church, and has all the best interests of the community at heart. Oh, of course, every muscle goes tight every time he passes a policeman. Oh, but what I think is that there are certain charges that ought not to be made. And I think I may add, ought not to be allowed to be made. We're all human. Who isn't? Oh, Mrs. Antrobus is as fine a woman as you can hope to see. She lives only for her children. And if it would be any benefit to her children, she'd be glad to see the rest of us stretched out dead at her feet without turning a hair. And that's the truth. If you want to know anything more about Mrs. Antrobus, just go and look at a tigress.
And look hard.
As for the children, well, Henry Antrobus is a real clean-cut American boy. He'll graduate from high school one of these days, if they make the alphabet any easier. Henry, when he has a stone in his hand, has a perfect aim. He can hit anything, from a bird to an older brother. I didn't mean to say that, but it was a very unfortunate accident. And it was very difficult getting the police out of the house. Mr. and Mrs. Antrobus's daughter is named Gladys. She'll make some good man a good wife someday. If he'll just come off the movie screen and ask her. So, here we are. We've managed to survive for some time now. Catch as catch can, the fat and the lean. And if the dinosaurs don't trample us to death, and if the grasshoppers don't eat up our garden, we'll all live to see better days. Knock on wood. Each new child that's born to the Antrobuses seems to them to have been sufficient reason for the whole universe's being set in motion. And each new child that dies seems to have been spared a whole world of sorrow. We've rattled along hot and cold for some time now, and my advice to you is to not inquire into why or whither, but just to enjoy your ice cream while it's on your plate. That's my philosophy. Don't forget that a few years ago, we came through the pandemic by the skin of our teeth. One more tight squeeze like that, and where will we be? We came through the pandemic by the skin of our teeth. One more tight squeeze like that, and where will we be? Oh! 6 o'clock, and the master not home yet. Pray God nothing serious happened to him crossing the LA River. Here it is, in the middle of August, in the coldest day of the year. It's simply freezing. The dogs are sticking to the...
Tell her to hurry up.
One more tight squeeze like that, and where will we be?
Make up something. Invent something.
This certainly is a fine American home, and, everybody's happy, and... I can't invent any words for this play, and I'm glad I can't. I hate this play, and every word in it. As for me, I don't understand a single word of it anyway. All about the struggles the human race has gone through, there's a subject for you, am I right? Besides, the author hasn't made up his silly mind as to whether we're all living back in caves, or in Florida. And that's the way it is, all the way through. Oh, why can't we have plays like we used to? Cats, Grease, Mamma Mia, Mamma Mia. Good entertainment with a message you can take home with you. I took this hateful job because I had to. For 2 years, I spent in my room, living on a sandwich and a cup of tea, waiting for better times in the theater. And look at me now. Who is in Hamlet and West Side Story and Mary Poppins. God in heaven.
Miss Juarez. Miss Juarez.
What? Oh. Anyway, nothing matters. It'll all be the same in 100 years. Don't forget that a few years ago, we came through the pandemic by the skin of our teeth. One more tight squeeze like that, and where will we be? Another. Don't know whether my wits are outside or in. Might as well be dead as alive in a house of sixes and sevens. You let the fire go out! Here it is, the coldest day of the year, right in the middle of August, and you've let the fire go out! Mrs. Antrobus, I'd like to give my notice, Mrs. Antrobus. A girl like I can get in a situation where they're rich enough to have a fire in every room. And a girl don't have to carry the responsibility of the whole house on her two shoulders. And a home without children, Mrs. Antrobus, because children are a thing only a parent can stand. And a truer word was never said. And a home, Mrs. Antrobus, where the master of the house doesn't pinch decent, self-respecting girls when he meets them in a dark corridor. I mention no names and make no charges. So, you have my notice, Mrs. Antrobus. 2 weeks. I hope that's perfectly clear. You've let the fire go out! Have you left the mammoth? I don't understand a word of this play. Yes, I've milked the mammoth. Until Mr. Antrobus comes home, we have no food and we have no fire. You'd better go over to the neighbors and borrow some fire. Mrs. Antrobus, I can't! I'd die on the way! You know I would! It's worse than January! The dogs are sticking to the sidewalks! I'd die!
Very well, I'll go.
You'd never make it out alive! We'd all perish if you weren't here! We'd just perish! How do we know, Mr. Antrobus, we'll be back in time? We don't know! If you go out, I'll just kill myself!
Get up, Sabina!
Every night, the same thing! Will he come back safe or won't he? Will we starve to death? Or freeze to death? Or boil to death? Will we be killed by burglars? I don't know why we go on living. I don't know why we go on living at all. It's easier being dead.
The same thing. Always throwing up the smoke. Always announcing your own death. They give you a new hat. Or a plate of ice cream. Or a ticket to the movies and you want to live forever. You don't care whether we live or die. All you care about is those children. And if it would be any benefit to them, you'd be glad to see the rest of us stretched out dead.
Well, maybe I would.
And what do they care about? Themselves. That's all they care about. They make fun of you behind your back. Don't tell me. Half the time, they're ashamed of you. Little things you get from them.
I'm not asking for any thanks.
Oh, and Mr. Antrobus. You don't understand him and all that work he does trying to discover the alphabet and the multiplication table. Whenever he tries to learn anything new, you fight against it.
Oh, Sabina, I know you. When Mr. Antrobus raped you home from your Sabine Hills, he did it to insult me. He did it for your pretty face and to insult me. You were the new wife, weren't you? For a year or two, you lay on your bed and painted the nails on your hands and feet. You made puffballs of the combings of your hair and blew them up to the ceiling. And I washed your underclothes. I made you chicken broths. I bore children, and between my very groans, I stirred the cream you'd put on your face. But I knew you wouldn't last. You didn't last.
But it was I who encouraged Mr. Antrobus to make the alphabet. I'm sorry to say it, Mrs. Antrobus, but you're not a beautiful woman. And you could never know what a man could do if he tried. It's girls like I who inspire that alphabet and multiplication table. I'm sorry to say it, Mrs. Antrobus, but you're not a beautiful woman. And that's the God's truth.
And you didn't last. You sank to the kitchen. And what did you do there? You let the fire go out. No wonder to you it seems easier being dead. Reading and writing and counting on your fingers is all very well in their own way, but I keep the home going. Oh, there's that dinosaur on the front lawn again. Chew! Go away, go away. You go around to the back of the house where you belong.
It's cold!
Now that you, audience, are listening to this too, I think I understand it a little better. Oh, I wish 11 o'clock were here. I don't want to be dragged through this whole play again.
What?
Are you sure? Maybe it's a trap.
I know there was, Sabina. We can open the door.
Children very far in a cold like this.
What's this text message you have for me?
If you wait just a minute, I've got to remember it.
Wow! This message was flashed from San Jose to Salinas! And then by puffs of smoke from Salinas to Bakersfield, and then by lantern from Chiraco Summits carried by messenger through the Moreno Valley of the Woolly Mammoth to your home in Hacienda Heights, California. What have God rot. Men! He knows that. Didn't he include the text? He always thinks he's so clever.
If you wait just a minute, I've got to remember it. To Mrs. Antrobus, Hacienda Heights, California. My dear wife will be an hour late, busy day at the office. Don't worry the children about the cold, just keep them warm. Burn everything except Shakespeare.
Men, he knows I'd burn 10 Shakespeares in order to prevent a child of mine from having one cold in the head. What does he say next?
Have made great discoveries today, have separated M from N.
Oh, I know what that is. That's the alphabet. Oh, Mr. Antrobus is just the cleverest man. Why, when the alphabet's finished, we'll be able to tell the future and everything.
Then listen to this. 10 tens make 100 semicolon consequences far-reaching.
The Earth's turning to ice, and all he can do is make up new numbers?
Well, Mrs. Antrobus, like the head man at our office said, a few more discoveries like that and we'll be worth freezing.
What does it say next?
I can't do this next part very well. Happy wedding anniversary to you.
Is that in the text? Is that in the text message? Are they singing text messages now or is that just in TikTok? The Earth's getting so silly. No wonder the sun turns cold.
Mrs. Antrobus, I want to take back the notice I gave you. I don't want to leave a house that receives such interesting text messages.
And I'm sorry for anything I said.
Really? I am.
Young person, I'd like to give you something for all this trouble. Mr. Antrobus isn't home yet, and I have no food and no money in the house.
Mrs. Antrobus, don't like to appear to ask for anything, but
what is it you'd like?
Do you happen to have an old needle you can spare? My wife just sits home all day thinking about needles.
Mrs. Antrobus, we only got two in the house. You know we only got two in the house. Why, yes, I can spare this.
Thank you, Mrs. Antrobus. Mrs. Antrobus, can I ask you something else? I have two sons of my own. The cold gets worse. What should I do?
I think we'll perish. That's what I think. Cold like this in the middle of August? This is just the end of the whole world.
don't know. After all, what does one do about anything? Just keep as warm as you can, and don't let your wife and children see that you're worried.
Thank you, Mrs. Antrobus. Well, I'd better be going. Oh! I forgot! There's one more sentence in the text! Three chairs have invented the wheel!
A wheel? What's a wheel?
I don't know. Sign for it's like this. Well, goodbye!
Snowballs.
Mama, it's so cold that in one more minute I couldn't have stood it.
Settle down, you two. I want to talk to you. It's just a cold spell of some kind. Now listen to what I'm saying. When your father comes home, I want you to be extra quiet. He's had a hard day at the office, and I don't know, but he may have one of his moods. I just got a telegram from him all happy and excited, and you know what that means. Your father's temper's uneven. I guess you know that. Henry! Henry, why can't you remember to keep your hand down over your forehead? You must keep that scar covered up. Don't you know that when your father sees it, he loses all control over himself? He goes crazy. He wants to die. Lift your head up and stop squirming. Blessed me. Sometimes I think it's going away, and then there it is, just as red as ever.
Mama, today at school, two teachers forgot and called me by my old name. They forgot, Mama. You'd better write another letter to the principal. So tell him I changed my name. Right out in class, they called me Kate.
Don't say it. If you're good, they'll forget it. Henry, you didn't hurt anyone today, did you?
No.
And Gladys, I want you to be especially nice to your father tonight. You know what he calls you when you're good? His little angel, his little star. Keep your dress down like a little lady and keep your voice nice and low. Gladys, Antrobus, what's that red stuff you have on your face? You're a filthy, detestable child! Get away from me, both of you! I wish I'd never seen the sight or sound of you. Let the cold come. I can't stand it. I don't want to go on.
All the girls at school do, Mama.
I'm through with you, that's all. Sabina! Sabina! Don't you know your father go crazy if he saw that paint on your face? Don't you know your father thinks you're perfect? Don't you know that your father die if he didn't think you were perfect? Sabina!
Yes, Mrs. Antrobus?
Take this girl into the kitchen and wash her face with the scrubbing brush. Sabina, what's that noise outside?
Oh, it's just a drunken tramp.
It's a giant! Mrs. Antrobus! We'll all be killed in our beds! I just know it! Help me quick! Everybody!
Open this door!
crooked family. I'll be starting it hard if a man can't get a little welcome when he comes home. Maggie, you look gunny sack. How's the broken down old weather hen? Sabina, old fish bait old stunt pot. And the children? How's the little smellers been?
Papa, 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 Papa!
How've they been, Maggie?
Well, I must say they've been as good as gold. I haven't had to raise my voice once. I don't know what's the matter with them.
Papa's little weasel, eh? Sabina, there's some food for you. Papa's little gopher?
Papa, you're always teasing me.
And Henry? Nothing rash today, I hope. Nothing rash?
No, Papa.
Oh, that's good. That's good. I bet Sabina let the fire go out.
Mr. Andrews, I'm giving my notice. I'm leaving 2 weeks from today. I'm sorry, but I'm leaving.
Well, if you leave now, you'll freeze to death. So go on and cook the dinner. Did you get my text message?
Yes. What's a wheel? What does this cold weather mean? It's below freezing.
Not before the children.
Shouldn't we do something about it? Start off, move.
Not before the children.
Oh, ah! Papa, you hit me!
Well, remember it. That'll make you remember today. Today, today, the alphabet finished. And the day we saw the hundredth, oh, there's no end to them. I had a day at the office. Take a good look at that wheel, Maggie. When I got that thing to rights, it'll be a sight. There's a reward for all the walking you've done.
How do you mean?
Maggie, we reached the top of the wave. There's not much left to be done. We're there.
And the ice?
The ice.
Oh, Papa, you could put a chair on this.
Yes, any booby can fool with it now, but I thought of it first.
Children, go play outside. I want to talk to your father alone. Well?
It's cold.
How things been, eh? And you, Millicent?
I know it's cold.
And no spilling of sunflower seeds, eh? No singing after lights out? You know what I mean?
You can try to prevent this freezing to death, can't you? You can do something. We can start moving or we can go on the animals' backs.
The best thing about animals is that they don't talk much.
It's cold.
Watch that. By midnight, we'll turn to ice. The roads are full of people who could scarcely lift a foot off the ground. The grass out in front is like iron. Which reminds me, I have another needle for you. The people up north, where are they? Frozen? Rushed.
Is that what's going to happen to us? Will you answer me?
I don't know. I don't know anything. Some say the ice is going slower. Some say that it stopped. Sun's growing colder. What can I do about that? Nothing we can do but burn everything in the house and the fence post in the barn. Keep the fire going. When we run out of fire, yeah, we die.
Well, why didn't you say so in the first place?
Mr.
Who's that? Who's that calling you?
Let me see.
Could we warm our hands for a moment, Mr. Antrobus? Very cold, Mr. Antrobus. Mr. Antrobus, I wonder if you have a piece of bread or something you can spare.
Who are these people? Why, they're all over the front yard. What did they come here for?
Mrs. Antrobus, there are some tramps knocking at the back door.
George, tell these people to go away. Tell them to move right along. I'll go and send them away from the back door. Sabina, come with me.
Sabina, stay there. I have something to say to you. Ladies and gentlemen, I have to ask you to wait a few minutes longer. It'll be all right. While you're waiting, might you each pull up a stake of the fence? We need them all for the fireplace. There'll be coffee and sandwiches in a moment.
Mr. Ackerman, what's that? That big white thing over there.
Sabina, I want you to go to the kitchen and make a lot of coffee, a whole pailful.
Pailful?
And sandwiches, piles of them like this.
Mr. N.
Oh, I know what this part of the play means. This means refugees. Oh, I don't like it. I don't like it.
This waters.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't take this place seriously.
The world's not coming to an end. You know it's not.
People exaggerate.
Most people really have enough to eat and a roof over their heads. Nobody actually starves.
You can always eat grass or something.
That whole ice business, why, that was a long time ago. Why, besides, these people were only savages. Savages don't love their families. Not like we do.
Miss Juarez!
All right, I'll say the line. But I won't think about the play. And I advise you not to think about the play either.
George, these tramps said that you asked them to come to the house. What does this mean?
They're a few friends met. Yeah, I met on the road.
Now don't you ask them in.
They're real nice, real useful people.
George Antrobus, not another soul comes in here over my dead body.
Maggie, there's a doctor there. Never hurts to have a good doctor in the house. We lost a peck of children one way or another. You can never tell when a child's throat gets stopped up. What you and I have seen.
All right, just one person, then the doctor. The others can go right along the road.
Maggie, there's an old man, a particular
friend. I won't listen to you.
It was he who really started off the ABCs.
I don't care if he perishes. We can do without reading or writing. We can't do without food.
Then let the ice come. Drink your coffee. I don't want any coffee, but I can drink it with good people.
Stop shouting. Who else is there trying to push us off the cliff?
Well, there's the man who makes all the laws, Judge Moses.
Judges can't help us now.
And if the ice melts, if we pull through, have you and I been able to bring up Henry? What have we done?
Who are those old women?
Up in town, there are 9 sisters. There are 3 or 4 of them there. They're sort of music teachers. One of them recites and one of
them... That's the end! A singing troupe! Well, take your choice. Live or die. Starve your children before your face!
And they don't take much. They're used to starving. They'll sleep on the floor. Besides, Maggie, listen. No, listen. Who we got in the house besides Sabina? Sabina's always afraid the worst will happen. Whose spirits can she keep up? Maggie, these people never give up. They think they'll live and work forever.
All right. Let them in. Let them in. But these animals must go. Enough's enough. They'll soon be big enough to push the walls down anyway. Take them away.
All right, the dinosaur and the mammoth. Come on, baby. Come on, Frederick. Come for a walk. That's a good little fellow.
It's cold!
Yes, nice cold fresh air. Make yourselves at home. Maggie, this is the doctor. Professor, this is my wife. Judge, Maggie, you know the judge. Maggie, you know Omero. Right, Maggie? Miss Muse, are some of your sisters here? Welcome, Miss E Muse, Miss T Muse, Miss M Muse.
Pleased to meet you. Just make yourselves comfortable. Supper will be ready in just a moment.
Make yourselves at home, friends. I'll be right back.
Me.
earth.
En el comienzo de todo, Dios creó el cielo y la tierra.
Now the earth was formless and empty.
La tierra no tenía ninguna forma.
Darkness was over the surface of the deep.
Todo era un mar cubierto de oscuridad.
And the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters.
Y el Espíritu de Dios se movía sobre el agua.
Dachtisuli mozrao datsklisi dapis.
And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light.
Entonces Dios dijo, "Que haya luz," y hubo luz.
God saw that the light was good.
Al ver Dios que la luz era buena.
And God separated the light from the darkness.
Y Dios la separó de la oscuridad.
God called the light day.
Y la llamó día.
And the darkness he called night.
Y a la oscuridad la llamó noche.
And God saw that it was good.
Y vio Dios que era bueno.
Amen.
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 Sabina, pass the sandwiches.
I thought I was working in a respectable house that had respectable guests. 2 weeks, Mr. Anchorvis, that's the law.
Sabina, pass the sandwiches.
2 weeks, that's the law.
There's the law. That's Moses.
The Ten Commandments! Ugh.
That's the worst line I've ever had to say on any stage.
I think it's best not to stand on ceremony, but pass the sandwiches from right to left. A judge, help yourself to, okay.
The roads are crowded out here.
People are trampling one another.
Ma'am, you can't imagine.
You can hardly put one foot before you.
You know what I think it is? I think it's sunspots.
Oh, you're right, Mrs. Anchorvis.
That's what it is.
That's what I was saying the other day.
Well, I don't think the whole world's gonna turn to ice. I can't believe it. Judge, have we worked for nothing? Professor, have we failed in the whole thing?
Well, it is certainly very strange. Well, on both sides of the family, we come of a very hardy stock. Oh, Doctor, I want you to meet my children. They're outside playing now, and of course, I want them to meet you.
How many children have you, Mrs. Andrews?
I have 2, a boy and a girl.
I understood you had 2 sons, Mrs. Andrews.
Abel? Abel, my son? Abel, my son! Abel, my son!
What's that?
Mr. Anchorvis, I don't stay in this house another moment! That boy of yours, that son Henry, he's not meant to live among respectable folks, and that's a fact!
Don't say another word, Sabina! I'll be right back!
Mr. Anchorvis, Henry has thrown another stone, and if he hasn't killed the boy that lives next door, I'm very much mistaken! He finished his supper and went out to play. And then I heard such a fight that I saw it. I saw it with my own eyes. And to me, it looked like stark murder.
He's gonna take the will away from me. He started to throw a stone at me first.
George, it was just a boyish impulse. Remember how young he is. George, he's only 4,000 years old.
And everything was going along so nicely.
Put out the fires! Put out all the fires! No wonder the sun grows cold!
Doctor! Judge! Help me! George, have you lost your mind?
There is no mind! We're not trying to live! Give it up! Give up trying!
George!
Anchorvis?
I have some more coffee. Gladys! Where's Gladys gone?
Here I am, Mama!
Go and bring your father's slippers! How could you forget a thing like that when you know how tired he is? Can't some of you sing? It's your business in life to sing, isn't it? Sabina! George, remember all the other times when the volcanoes came right up in the front yard and the time the grasshoppers ate every single leaf and blade of grass and all the grain and spinach you've grown with your own hands. And the summer, there were earthquakes every night.
Henry, myself, all of us, we're covered with blood.
Then remember all the times when you were pleased with him
and when you were proud of yourself. Henry?
Yes, Mama?
Come here and recite to your father the multiplication tables that you do so nicely.
2 times 6 is 12. 3 times 6 is 18. I don't think I know the sixes.
Papa, I was very good in school today. Miss Conover said right out in class that if all the girls had as good manners as Gladys Antrobus, that the world would be a very different place to live in.
You recited a piece at assembly, didn't you? Recite it to your father.
Papa, do you want to hear what I recited in class?
The Star by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. The night is come, but not too soon, and sinking silently.
Wait! The fire's going out!
All silently, the little moon drops down behind the sky.
We're going to have to break down the chairs and the beds.
There is no light on earth or heaven, but the cold light of the stars.
We're going to have to break down the chairs and the beds!
And the first watch of night is given to the red planet Mars.
Papa, look!
Here's my report card! Look it! Papa, did you like The Star by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow? Papa, you're not mad at me, are you? I know it'll get warmer. Soon, it'll be just like spring. And we can go to a picnic at Big Bear like you always like to do. Don't you remember?
Papa, just look at me once!
You recited in assembly, did you? You didn't forget?
No, I was perfect.
Build up the fire, it's cold. Build up the fire, we'll do what we can. Sabina, get more wood. Come around the fire, everybody. At least the young ones may pull through. Henry, have you eaten something?
Yes, Papa.
Gladys, have you had some supper?
I ate in the kitchen, Papa.
If we do come through this, what would you two be able to do? What do you know?
Henry, take a good look at that wheel.
Yes, Papa.
6 times 2 are...
12. 6 times 3 are 18. 6 times 4 are... Papa, it's hot and cold. It makes my head all funny. It makes me sleepy.
Wake up! I don't care if your head is sleepy. 6 times 4 is 24. 6 times 5 are...
30, Papa.
Maggie, put something on Gladys' head on a chance she gets to use it.
What should it be, George?
6 times 6 is 36. Teach her the beginning of the Bible.
But Mama, it's so cold and close.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
God created the heavens and the earth.
And the earth. Will you please start passing up your chairs?
We'll leave everything for this fire.
Ushers, will you please pass up your chairs? Never mind. I'll do it myself.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
The earth was waste and void.
And the earth was waste and void.
And the darkness was a
pass up your chairs, everybody! Save the human race!
Thank you.
the news and events of the world.
Between members in Gilbert? Gilbert! There's so many of us here. But for the last million years, I have been rapacious, hairy, and diaphragmatic.
Thank you very much, Mr. Andrews. Now, I know that our visitors will wish to hear a few words from that gracious and charming now, Mrs. Andrews, wife and mother, Mrs. Andrews!
Contest that took place here today. Mr. Andrews, an experienced
the citadel. You'll have 6 grandchildren. Everyone has laces. Cirrhosis of the liver.
Your home, That's all I can say. Try and be a lady. Goodness, where's Henry?
Jumpy!
He was just here a minute ago. Henry!
Well, put your eye out.
I want you! I want you!
I've never yelled
you
before.
You make me mad, you'll get hurt.
Henry, what is this? Put down your slingshot.
Henry, behave yourself.
That's right, Edmund. There are too many people in the world of entities. Everybody sits away except yourself.
All I wanted to do was have some fun.
Fun? Nobody can touch my Wiimobile without I allowed to. Now you get clean away from me, and you get away fast.
What are you doing, Henry?
Everyone's always getting mad. Everyone's always trying to push you around. I'll make them sorry for this. I'll make them sorry.
Give me your slingshot.
I won't. I'm sorry I came to this place. Wish I weren't here. Wish I weren't anywhere.
No, Henry, don't get so excited about nothing. I declare I don't know what we're going to do with you. Put your slingshot in your pocket and don't try to take a hold of things that don't belong to you.
After this, you can go home. I wash my hands of you.
Come now, let's forget all about it. Everybody take a good breath of that desert air and calm down. Who was that man you spoke to, George?
Nobody, Maggie. Just the candidate who ran against me in the election.
The man who ran against you in the election? My husband didn't speak to you. He'll never speak to you.
Now, Maggie.
After all those lies you told about him in your speeches, why is that what I want?
Mama, everybody's looking at you. Everybody's laughing at you.
You must know my husband's a saint, a downright saint, and you're not going to speak to him on the street.
Now, Maggie, that's enough of that. Someday you're gonna drive me crazy.
All right, go. I'll just sit here and laugh at you, and you can give me my dollars right in my hand. Mark my words, a rainy day is coming. There's a rainy day ahead of us. I feel it in my bones.
Maggie, I tell you, there's a limit to what I can stand. Haven't I proved enough? Don't I get any vacation? Can't I give my kids so much for riding a Wiimobile?
Anyway, it's going to rain very soon, and you have your broadcast to make.
Maggie, you're driving me crazy! A man can stand a family only just so long! I'm warning you!
George, Andrew, how could you say such a thing? You have the best family in the world! People are coloring.
Good morning, Miss Fairweather.
Gondola knows her too. Mama, he knows her well.
Henry, come here. She's a very nice girl in every way, and is so supportive of her mother.
So was Sabina! So was Sabina! And it took a wall of ice to open your eyes about Sabina! Henry, come over here and sit down on this bench.
She's a very different matter from Sabina. Miss Fairweather's a college graduate, Phi Beta Kappa.
Henry, you see here by Mama, Gladys.
reduced circumstances have required her taking a position as hostess in a bingo parlor. There isn't a girl with higher principles in the country.
Well, let's not talk about it. Henry, I haven't seen a desert tortoise yet.
She speaks 7 languages and has more culture on her little finger than you have acquired in a lifetime.
All right! All right, George. I'm glad to know there are such superior girls in the bingo parlor. Henry, what's that?
What is it, Papa?
Oh, that's the storm signal.
One of those lights means possibility of rain. 2 means flash flooding. 3 means monsoonal flooding and snowmelt. 4 means the end of the world.
Goodness! I'm going this very minute to buy you all some raincoats.
Oh, Mama, don't go yet. I like sitting this way. And the wind coming in and in.
Well, there's only one thing I lack to make me a perfectly happy woman. I'd like to see a desert tortoise.
Mama, I saw 2 right out there. They're delegates to the convention. I'll find you one.
Papa, ask me something. Ask me a question.
Well, how big's the Mojave Desert?
Papa, you're teasing me. The Mojave Desert is 20 million acres and 31,000 square miles long. The Mojave Desert is often referred to as the High Desert, as most of it lies between 2,000 and 4,000 feet in altitude.
No, Papa, ask me something hard, real hard.
I'm going off to buy raincoats. I don't care if it's never got to number 3. I think the bad weather's going to get worse and worse. I hope it doesn't come before your broadcast. I should think we have about an hour or so.
I hope it comes in now.
Henry,
everything before.
Henry.
I hope it.
George, call it women's intuition, but I think it's one of those number 3 storms when you're just as safe and safer in a good stout boat.
There's a boat at the Venetian. It's a big gondola.
That's good to know. I think we're going to need it. George, you shut your eyes and get a good rest before the broadcast.
Thundering Judas, do I have to be told when to open and shut my eyes? Go on, buy your raincoats.
And children, you have 10 minutes to walk around. 10 minutes. And Henry, control yourself. And Gladys, stick by your brother and don't get lost. Will you be all right, George?
Here she comes.
What's he doing?
Oh, he's ready for you. Quite your relief, dear. Take a long breath and come on up.
Oh, I'm nervous. My whole future depends on this. I'm nervous.
Don't be a fool. What more could he want? He's 45. He sits a little dizzy.
He has just been elected president.
He's never known any other woman than his wife. Whenever he looks at her, he realizes that she knows every foolish thing he has ever done.
Mr. Antrobus, dare I speak to you for a moment?
Oh, certainly. Certainly, Miss Fairweather.
Oh, Mr. Antrobus, I've been so unhappy. I wanted to make sure that you don't think that I'm the type of girl to go out for beauty contests.
That's a wait.
Oh, I understand. I understand perfectly.
Oh, I knew you would. Just this morning, my mother said to me, Lily, she said, that fine Mr. Antrobus gave you the prize because he knew at once that you weren't the kind of girl to go in for a thing like that. But honestly, Mr. Antrobus, honestly, in this world, a good girl doesn't know where to turn.
Oh, you have got too far.
My dear Miss Fairweather.
You wouldn't know how hard it is with that lovely wife, daughter you have. Oh, I just think Mrs. Antrobus is the finest woman I ever saw. I wish I were more like her.
There's all kinds of different people in the world, Miss Fairweather.
Oh, how wonderful of you to say that. How generous. Mr. Antrobus, have you a moment free?
I'm afraid I may be a little conspicuous out here. Would you come down for a moment? I have a cabana by the pool.
Why, certainly, for a moment. Just for a moment.
Oh, look! There's a comfortable looking spot. Because, you know, you do look tired. Just this morning, my mother said to me, Lily, she said, I hope Mr. Antrobus is getting good rest. His fine, strong face has deep, deep lines in it. Now, isn't it true, Mr. Antrobus? You work too hard.
Bingo!
Now, you come along and just stretch out. No, I shan't say a word. Not a word. I shall just stand here. Privilege. That's what I am.
Miss Fairweather, you'll spoil me.
Just a moment. I have something I wish to say to the audience. Ladies and gentlemen, I am not going to play this particular scene tonight. It's just a short scene, and we're just going to skip it. But I can tell you what takes place and what goes on, and we can continue the play from there on. Now, in this scene,
Miss Juarez!
I'm sorry, but I have to skip it. In this
Vince.
Scene, Mr. Antrobus decides to leave his wife, get a divorce at Reno, and marry me. That's all. So, now that I've told you, we can just jump to the end of it. Where you say, what? Where'd he go?
Miss Juarez! We insist that you play the scene.
I'm sorry, Mr. Fitzpatrick, but I can't and I won't. I've told the audience all they need to know, and now we can go on.
Why can't you play it?
Because there are some lines in that scene that would hurt some people's feelings, and I don't think the theater is a place where people's feelings ought to be hurt.
Miss Juarez, you can pack up your things and go. I shall call the understudy, and I shall report you to Equity.
I sent the understudy up to the corner for a cup of coffee, and if Equity tries to penalize me, I'll bring the case right up to Supreme Court. Now, everybody, listen. There's no need to get excited.
Why can't you play it? What's the matter with the scene?
Well, if you must know, there's a girl in this cast, and her life hasn't exactly been a happy one. If
don't
you know
my marriage.
I don't suppose it occurred to the author that some other women may have gone through the experience of losing their husbands like this. Wild horses are going to drag me from the details of my friend's life! But, well, you know, they've been married 20 years! And before he got rich, why, she'd done the washing and everything! As for the other harrowing detail,
Miss
Juarez!
Miss Juarez! Haiti, your friend will forgive you. We must play the scene.
Nothing will make me say some of those lines about how a man outgrows his wife every 7 years. And that one about how he is the only one who looks the subject square in the face. Nothing.
Oh. Miss Juarez, go to your dressing room. I'll read your lines myself.
Ugh. Now everybody's nerves are on edge.
Just skip the scene.
Thank you. I knew you'd understand. We'll just do what I said. So, Mr. Antrobus is going to leave his wife and marry me. Mr. Antrobus, this is where you say,
it won't be easy to lay all this before my wife.
Wait a minute. I can't go back into it as easily as all that.
Oh, my God.
My wife's a very obstinate woman. Then you say, what do you say? Miss Fairweather, I mean, Lily, it won't be easy to lay all this before my wife. It'll hurt her feelings a little.
Listen, George, other people haven't got feelings. Not in the same way we have. We, who are presidents like you, and prize winners like me. Listen, other people haven't got feelings. They just imagine they have. Within 2 weeks, they go back to playing bridge and going to the movies. Now, listen. Darling, there's a kind of secret society at the top of the world, like you and me, that know this. What is life anyway, except for two things, pleasure and power? What is life? Boredom.
those two things, life's nauseating. So, come here. Now, it's really very simple. When your wife comes, just tell her.
Lily, Lily, you're a wonderful woman.
Oh, of course I am.
Like, it is. All the things that a woman knows. It's never been told to any man, and it's never been told to any woman. And if it finds its destination, a new time will come. We're not what books, movies, and plays say that we are. We're not what advertisements say we are. We're not in the movies, and we're not on the radio. We're not what you're all told and what you think we are. We're ourselves. And if any man can find one of us, he'll learn why the whole universe was set in motion. And if any man harm one of us, his soul, the only soul he's got, had better be at the bottom of that ocean, and that's the only way to put it.
To make Dinky Dover!
Antropus? Gladys? Where are you?
I told him the places.
The war's over. Peace treaty's been signed.
You're not there.
Mrs. Antropus? Gladys?
Where are they?
No. Are they dead too?
Figure something out.
Mrs. Antropus! Gladys!
Unbelievable!
Mr. Antropus will be here this morning!
It's a doll man!
I just saw him downtown!
When? Now!
Mr.
Sorry, at the emergency switch. Go ahead.
Of course I'm going to go ahead. There's nothing wrong, ladies and gentlemen. That was a mistake. I'm sorry. Ladies and gentlemen, we have to stop the production. We have a problem. I thought we solved it. But along with all the other things going on, with Miss Juarez and her friend and the production, and she's been, and you saw. Anyway, nothing against Miss Juarez. She has her standards. We all have our standards. But it's my responsibility, and it's been difficult. I'm losing my hair! So we have to stop momentarily. Let me explain. You see, if you noticed, in our program, there are four professors, or former professors, from Elac playing the voices of wisdom, as it were in the final act. Well, these four colleagues went out last night to a well-known establishment around here, the Venice Room. I think they thought it was ironic with the whole gondola motif in the second act. I mean, they are professors. They'd normally think of something like that. And let me add, they don't normally go to establishments like of that kind. But they went, and apparently, but not for sure, but because of the close environment and they weren't wearing masks, they tested positive for the COVID virus right after the show began and are now in quarantine in the girls' bathroom. But as luck would have it, I didn't find out about it until after the second act began. I mean, Tim, he just heard over the microphone, kept on saying it was an emergency, and I knew it was an emergency. Now, Tim did his part, and he found four of the ensemble to take their places. I mean, they've been to all the rehearsals and everything. But again, I did not know anything about this until it was too late. Because the director, with his endless tinkering with this play, thought it would be most effective to have the voices of wisdom coming from above. But that meant moving into places, as we call it, during the transition between the acts. But it didn't happen because I didn't know about it. So we have to do it now. So there it is. As you can see, they are moving into spot right now. As to their effectiveness, I really couldn't say. They are the voices of wisdom. Not right now, Ivy.
What were you going to say,
Ivy? On stage, Dana.
Mr. Fitzpatrick, my father's a Baptist minister, and he said that the director wanted us to think that, just like the stars and hours that go by over our heads at night, in the same way the thoughts and ideas of the great thinkers are in the air all around us, all the time, and they're working on us, even if we don't know it.
Well, maybe that's it, Ivy. Thanks. Okay, you're in your place, Ivy, and I think we better start again.
So, as they say in the film biz, everyone back to A. Take two. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the third act, once again, of The Skin of Our Teeth. Go, Tim. Go!
Bring the milk to the door.
As soon as he catches a cow.
for him to catch a cow, dear.
My, shoe polish. My, I've forgotten what priest time was like.
Mrs. Antrobus, guess what I saw Mr. Antrobus doing this morning at dawn? He was tackling up a piece of paper on the door of the town hall. You'll die when you hear. It was a recipe for grass soup. For a grass soup that doesn't give you the diarrhea. Huh. Mr. Antrobus is still thinking up new things. He told me to give you his love. He's got all sorts of ideas for peacetime, he says. No more laziness and idiocy, he says. And oh, where are his books? What? We'll pass them up. The first thing he wants to see are those books. He says that if you burnt those books, or if the rats have eaten them, he says it isn't worthwhile starting over again. Oh, everybody's going to be beautiful, he says, and diligent and very intelligent. Ooh, mold. And he's got such plans for you, Mrs. Antrobus. You're going to study history and algebra, and so are Gladys and I, and philosophy. Oh, you should hear him talk.
Well, these are in English anyway.
Oh, to hear him talk seems like he expects you to be a combination, Mrs. Antrobus, of a saint and a college professor and a dance hall hostess, if you know what I mean. Ah, yes, peace will be here before we know it.
Ugh. German.
Ah, yes, as I was saying, peace will be here before we know it. In a week or two, we'll be asking the Perkinsons for a quiet evening of bridge. We'll turn on the TV and hear about how to be big successes with a new toothpaste. We'll trot down to the movies and hear about how girls with wax faces live. And all that will begin again. Oh, Mrs. Antrobus, God forgive me, but I enjoyed the war. Everybody's at their best in wartime. Oh, I'm sorry it's over. Oh, I forgot. Mr. Antrobus sent you another message. Can you hear me? Listen, Henry's never to put foot in this house again. He'll kill Henry on sight if he sees him. You don't know about Henry? Where have you been? Well, listen, Henry rose right to the top. Top of what? Listen, I'm telling you, Henry rose from corporal to captain to major to general. I don't know how to say it, but the enemy is Henry. Henry is the enemy. Everybody knows that.
Oh, kill me, will he?
Who are you? I'm not afraid of you. The war's over.
I'll kill him so fast. I've spent 7 years trying to find him. All the others I killed were just substitutes.
Goodness, it's Henry. Oh, I'm not afraid of you. The war's over, Henry Antrobus. And you're not as any important as any of the other unemployed. Now you go away and hide yourself until we find a way to calm your father down.
The first thing to do is burn up those old books. It's the ideas he gets out of those old books that makes the whole world so you can't live in it.
You leave those books alone. Mr. Antrobus is looking forward to them. Gracious sakes, Henry. You're so tired you can't stand up. Your mother and sister will be here in a minute. Then we'll figure out what to do about you.
What did they ever care about me?
There's that old wine again. All you people think you're not loved enough. Nobody loves you. Well, you start being lovable and make people love you.
I don't want anybody to love me.
Then stop talking about it all the time.
I never talk about it. The last thing I want is anybody to pay any attention to me.
I can hear it behind every word you say.
I want everybody to hate me.
Yes, you've decided that second best, but it's still the same thing. Mrs. Antrobus! Henry's here. He's so tired he can't stand up.
Henry?
Henry!
Have you anything to eat?
Yes, I've been saving something for this very day. 2 good baked potatoes. potatoes. No, Henry, one of them's for your father. Henry, give me that other potato back this minute.
He's so dog tired, he doesn't know what he's doing.
You just rest there until I can get your room ready and eat that potato good and slow so you can get all the nourishment out of it.
Look, you all might as well know right now, I haven't come back here to live.
Shh, I'll put this blanket over you. Your room's hardly damaged at all. Your football trophies are a little tarnished, but Sabina and I will polish them up tomorrow.
Did you hear me? What I don't live here. I don't belong to anybody.
Henry, how could you say a thing like that? You certainly do belong right here. Where else would you want to go? Your forehead's feverish, Henry, seems to me. You better give me that gun, Henry. You won't need that anymore.
Look, he's fallen asleep already with his potato half chewed.
Ugh, terror of the world.
Sabina, you mind your business and start putting the room to rights.
That's all we ever do. Always beginning again. Over and over again. Always beginning again. How do we know to be any better than before? Why can we go on pretending? Someday, the whole world's gonna have to grow cold anyway. And until that time comes, there'll be all these other things happening. There'll be more wars, and more walls of ice, and more blood being earthquakes! Stop arguing and go on with your work.
All right. I'll just go out of habit.
But I won't believe in it. Now, Sabina, I've let you talk long enough. I don't want to hear any more of it.
Do I have to explain to you what everybody knows? Everybody who keeps a home going. Do I have to say to you what nobody should ever have to say because they can see it in each other's eyes? Now listen to me. I could live for 70 years in a cellar and make soup out of grass and bark without ever doubting that this world has work to do and will do it. Do you hear me?
Yes, Mrs. Enchervis.
Sabina, do you see this house? 216 Disfruta, do you see it?
Yes, Mrs. Enchervis.
Well, just to have known this house is to have seen what we can do if we keep our wits about us. Too many people have suffered and died in order to make my children rich for us to start reneging now. So we'll go on putting this room to rights. Now, Sabina, go and see what you can do in the kitchen.
Kitchen. Why is it that no matter how far I go, I always find myself back in the kitchen?
Goodness gracious! What did you know? My father was a parson. It was just like I heard his own voice, and he's been dead 5,000 years. There, I've gone and waked Henry up.
Fellows, what have they done for us? Blocked our way at every step, kept everything in their own hands, and you stood it. When are you going to wake up?
Shh, Henry. Go to sleep. Go to sleep. There. That looks better. Mama, I'm going out into the backyard and hold the baby up in the air and show him that we don't have to be afraid anymore.
All right. What have you got to lose? What have they done for us? That's right. Nothing. Tear everything down. I don't care what you smash. Begin again. We'll show them. Sisters, and I don't want any. And what's more, I never got anybody over me. And I never will have. I'm alone. And that's all I want to be. Alone. So you can shoot me.
You're the last person I wanted to see. The sight of you dries up all my plans and hopes. I wish we were back at war still, because it's easier to fight than to live with you. War is a pleasure, do you hear me? War is a pleasure compared to what faces us now. Trying to build a peacetime with you in the middle of it.
I'm not going to be a part of any peacetime with yours.
I'm going a long way from here and make my own will as fit for a man to live in. Where a man can be free and have a chance and do what he wants to do in his own way.
Henry, let's try again.
Try what? Living here? Speaking polite downtown to all the old men like you? Standing like a sheep at the street corner until the red light turns to green? Being a good boy and a good sheep, like all the stinking ideas you get out of your books. Oh no, I'll make a world and I'll show you.
How can you make a world for people to live in unless you first put order in yourself? Mark my words, I shall continue fighting you until my last breath. As long as you mix up your idea of freedom with your idea of hugging everything for yourself, I shall have no pity for you. I shall pursue you to the far corners of the earth. You and I want the same thing. But until you think of it as something that everyone has a right to, you are my deadly enemy, and I will destroy you. I hear your mother's voice in the kitchen. Have you seen her?
Nina?
I have no mother. Get it into your head. I don't belong here. I have nothing to do here. I have no home.
Then why did you come here? Of all the world to choose from, why did you come to this one place? Dos y si seis calle disfruta. Well,
what if I did? What if I wanted to look at it once more to see if...
Oh, you're related to me, all right? When your mother comes in, you must behave yourself. Do you hear me?
What is this must behave yourself? Don't you say must to me?
Quiet!
Nobody can say must to me. All my life, everybody's been crossing me. Everyone, everything, all of you. I'm gonna be free. Even if I have to kill half the world for it. Right now, too. Let me get my hands on his throat. I'll show him.
Stop the play, Mark! You know what happened last night. Stop the play! Ladies and gentlemen, I forbid these men to play the scene. Last night, Roman strangled him. He became a regular savage. Stop it!
It's true. I'm sorry. I don't know what comes over me. I have nothing against him personally. I respect him very much. I admire him. But something comes over me. It's like I become 15 years old again. Listen, my own father used to whip me and lock me up every Saturday night. I never had enough to eat. He never let me have enough money to buy any decent clothes. I was ashamed to go downtown. I never could go to the dances. My father and my uncle put rules in the way of everything I wanted to do. They tried to prevent my living at all. I'm sorry.
No, go on. Finish what you were saying. Say it all.
In the scene, it's as though we're back in high school again. Like I had some big emptiness inside of me. The emptiness of being hated and blocked at every turn. And the emptiness fills up with one thought. That you have to strike and fight and kill. Listen, it's as though you have to kill somebody else so as to not end up killing yourself.
That's not true. I knew your father, and your uncle, and your mother. You imagined all that. Why, they did everything they could for you. How could you say things like that? They didn't lock you up.
They did. They wished they hadn't been born.
That's not true.
Wait a minute. I have something to say too. It's not wholly his fault that he wants to strangle me in this scene. It's my fault too. He wouldn't feel that way unless there was something in me that reminded him of all that. He talks about emptiness. Well, there's an emptiness in me too. Work, work, work. That's all I do. I've ceased to live. No wonder he feels that anger coming over him.
There. At last you've said it.
We're all just as wicked as we can be. And that's the God's truth.
Come. Come and let's get some fresh air.
I'll go with him. I've known him longer. You have to continue with the play. Come on, Gio.
Thanks. Thanks for what you said. I'll be all right tomorrow. I won't lose control in that place.
Happens to the best of us. It's okay.
George, you're limping?
Yes, a little. My old wound from the other war started smarting again. I can manage.
Some lights are coming on. First in 7 years! People are walking up and down looking at them. Some people over in Hawkins, they built a bonfire to celebrate the peace. They're dancing around it like scarecrows.
A bonfire? As though they haven't seen enough things burning. Maggie, the dog died?
Oh yes, long ago. There are no dogs left in the Hacienda Heights. You're back again. All these years I gave up counting on letters. The few that arrived were 6 months to a year late.
Yes, the ocean's full of letters, along with the other things.
George, sit down, you're tired.
No, you sit down. I'm tired, but I'm restless. Maggie, I've lost it.
What, George, what have you lost?
The most important thing of all, the desire to begin again, to start building.
Well, it'll come back.
I've lost it. This minute, I feel like all those people dancing around the bonfire. Just relief. Just the desire to settle down, to slip in the old grooves, and keep the neighbors from walking over my lawn. But during the war, in the middle of all that blood and dirt and hot and cold every day and night, I had moments, Maggie, when I saw the things we could do when it was over. I've lost it. I feel sick and tired.
Listen, I hear the baby crying. I hear Gladys talking. Probably she's quieting Henry again. George, when Gladys and I were living here, like moles, like rats, and when we were at our wits' end trying to save the baby's life, the only thought we clung to was that you were going to bring something good out of this suffering. In the night, in the dark, we'd whisper about it, starving and sick. Oh, George, you'll have to bring it back again somehow. Think, what else kept us alive all these years? Even now, it's not comfort we want. We can do whatever's necessary. Only give us back that promise.
Mrs. Antrobus?
Yes, Sabina?
Oh, you need me?
No, Sabina, you can go to bed.
Mrs. Antrobus, if it's all right with you, I'd like to go to the bonfire and celebrate. The war's over. And Mrs. Antrobus, they've opened up the Gem Movie Theater, and they're giving a hand-painted soup tureen to every lady, and, well, I thought one of us ought to go.
Well, Sabina, I haven't had any money. I haven't seen any money for quite a while.
Oh, but you need money. They're taking anything you can give them. And I have some... Mrs. Antrobus, promise you won't say anything. It's a little against the law. But I'll give you some, too.
What is it?
I'll give you some, too. Last night, I picked up a lot of... beef cubes.
But, Sabina, you know you have to give that into the center downtown. They know who needs them most.
Mrs. Andrews, I didn't make this war! I didn't ask for it! And in my opinion, after everybody's gone through what we've gone through, they have the right to grab what they can find.
You're a very nice man, Mr. Antrobus. But you'd got on better in the world if you'd realize that dog eat dog was the rule at the beginning. And always will be. Most of all now. Oh, the world's an awful place. And you know it is. I used to think something could be done about it. But I know better now. I hate it.
All right. You can have.
Thank you, Savina.
Can I have one to go to the movies? Thank you.
Good night, Savina.
Mr. Antipas, don't mind what I say. I'm just an ordinary girl. You know what I mean. I'm just an ordinary girl. But you're a bright man, a very bright man. And you, of course, you invented the alphabet and the wheel and, my God, a lot of things. And if you have any other ideas, my God, don't let me accept them. Only every now and then I've got to go to the movies. But if you have any other plans on improving this crazy old world, I'm with you. I really am. Because it's... Well, it's... Good night.
Now I remember the three things that always went together when I was able to see things most clearly. Three things. The voice of the people in their confusion and their need, the thought of you and the children and this house. And Maggie, I dare not ask you, my books, they haven't been lost, have they?
No, there are some of them here, kind of scattered.
Yes, remember Maggie, we almost lost them once before. And when we finally did collect a few torn copies out of the old cellars, they ran in everyone's head like a fever. They're as good as rebuilt the world. Oh, I've never forgotten for a long of a time that living is a struggle. I know every good and excellent thing stands moment by moment on the razor edge of danger and must be fought for, whether it's a field or a home or a country. All I ask is the chance to build new worlds, and God has always given us that second chance and has given us voices to remind us and the memory of our mistakes to warn us. Maggie, you and I must remember in peacetime all those resolves that were so clear to us in days of war. Maggie, we've come a long ways. We've learned, we're learning, and the steps to our journey are marked for us here. You know, sometimes out there in the war, standing on the hill, I try to remember some of the words of these books.
Whatever happens. They do not speak vain words and are the same in good fortune and bad. If one chooses not children, nor wealth, nor power, nor success by any unfair means, know such a one to be good, wise, and virtuous.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth was waste and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Lord said, "Let there be light," and there was light.
Look! And the master not home yet. Pray God nothing serious happened in crossing the LA River. But I wouldn't be surprised. The whole world's at sixes and sevens. And why the house hasn't fallen down about our ears long ago is a miracle to me.
This is where you come in. We have to go on for ages and ages, yet you go home.
The end of this play isn't written yet. Mr. and Mrs. Antrobus, their heads are filled with all sorts of ideas for the future, and they're as confident as the day it first began. And they told me to tell you good night.
Should come with me to the end of the world without telling your parents and your friends. You that she only needs faith. To my friend.